Let's do a quick review of multiplicity in proton NMR. Okay, so we have four different types of neighbors. Multiplicity is going to be equal to n plus 1, but we have four different types of neighbors. Homotopic, enantiotopic, both of these are going to split identically to one another for their neighbor. And then diastereotopic and heterotopic are going to split differently. Okay, so let's look at a simple example and then put these to work. And let's label our spectrum with A, B, C, and D for four observable signals. And so methyl protons that are next door to an allylic position, we'll shift to this position, so 3H here, the integration of 3, and these guys are going to be C. All right, a singlet means zero neighbors, because 1 minus 1 is 0, so zero neighbors here for the singlet. These three are also homotopic, okay? And then we have another allylic position, the protons we've labeled D. The D protons here are enantiotopic to one another, and their neighbors are enantiotopic. So these neighbors for our signal D here are enantiotopic, and they will split D equivalently. So what we have here is a triplet, which means we have two neighbors. So we integrate to 2 because we're a CH2, and we have two identical neighbors as far as splitting is concerned. So we get a triplet. Okay, and then on the other end of the spectrum, we have our molecule. We have A here, the other methyl protons integrate to just under 1, and they have two neighbors. So here's A, here are the neighbors of A at 1.6. So two enantiotopic neighbors. Okay, you change one, you change the other to a deuterium, for example, versus a hydrogen, you get R and S. So we have enantiotopic protons, no existing chiral center. They split the same. So again, two neighbors splitting the same way. We integrate to 3. A triplet means we have two neighbors. But then we have the protons that we will label B. And so B has a couple of different types of neighbors. If we're just looking at proton B, or the protons at B, they don't split each other because they're enantiotopic. They give the same signal. But they have two neighbors of one type and three neighbors of another. Okay, so they've got multiple neighbors. We've got an integration of 2 here, and this is a multiplet. Okay, because it's got two different types, heterotopic, A and D are heterotopic to one another. They're going to give different splitting. And so to explain complex splitting and how it works, we have more than one type of neighbor. So either heterotopic or diastereotopic relationship of one neighbor to another. For example, we have six neighbors of one type here because we have the same homotopic relationship of both of these methyl groups by a rotation of 180 degrees about the molecule. These are six true neighbors of one type. Okay, so A is homotopic. These are homotopic neighbors. And so they all split the same. So we would expect to see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, a splitting of 7, a septet for these. And that's a normal splitting pattern. Now the heights of those peaks are not perfect by Pascal's triangle, but it's a septet for homotopic neighbors of that type. A heterotopic neighbor, such as we have here, we'll label these A to B. These are different than one another. We have three neighbors of one type, and we have two neighbors of the other type. These are heterotopic to one another because if we change one of them to a deuterium, for example, we get constitutional isomers. We get different name for the compound. They are different. And so here, we would get complex splitting or multiplet. The other way is to have diastereotopic neighbors. So if we consider the hydrogen I've highlighted in yellow here, it has one neighbor of one type, one neighbor of another, and then a diastereotopic neighbor to that. So these two are diastereotopic to one another. They split differently. They split their neighbor differently. And this red here is diastereotopic to the original nitrogen marked in yellow. And so it actually gives a different splitting. So you end up with a multiplet as well for these. Now, the effect of the splitting depends on the coupling constant, which is abbreviated J. So for a simple triplet, for example, the coupling constant is the difference here measured in hertz, which are related to ppm. It's just the difference in the distance on between these two. So you've got a coupling constant that's the same for both of these peaks. Okay, and so if we've got a multi-spin system such as above, so let's redraw what we've got so we had B here, and so we've got two neighbors of this type, which we labeled D and A. Okay, so D and A, and then three neighbors of this type. So let's suppose that the coupling constant between A and B is greater than the coupling constant between B and D. And so these are going to split into a quartet, because N plus 1, three neighbors plus 1 is 4. These are going to split the signal from B into a triplet, neighbors 2 plus 1. Well, if the coupling constant of A is bigger than the coupling constant between A and B and B and D, then we're going to end up with a quartet of triplets. Okay, and so if it's much, much greater, we will resolve all of these into a quartet of triplets. So what we've got are triplets individually, and then overall a quartet of those. Okay, so we've got a quartet and a triplet blended together. If we reverse this situation and say, well, the coupling constant between A and B is less than the coupling constant between B and D, so B and D is greater, we're going to have a triplet of quartets. So in the first example, the quartet J looked like this. Here's J, A, B, and then little bitty J between B and D. And in the next example here, the triplet of quartets, we're going to see 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to see that the coupling constant of B and D to make the triplet, so here's the triplet, 1, 2, 3, versus the 4 smaller, the complex spin results in a big coupling constant for B and D and a small between A and B. And if those coupling constants are equal, then the old N plus 1 rule works, and so we have a total of 3 plus 2 is 5. 5 neighbors plus 1 equals 6. We get our true sextet as we normally would. And again, the heights are not perfect, but we would get our N plus 1 splitting as normal. So it all depends on those coupling constants as to what it looks like for the complex spin system. And if the value of the coupling constants are unknown, the values are unknown, then we would just call it a multiplet and be done with it, rather than a quartet of triplets or a triplet of quartets. If we don't know, just call it a multiplet and be done with it.